Good morning. The US stocks took off well after a President's Day break after strong revenues from drug maker Merck. The Dow Jones Industrial Average rose by 170 points to end at 10,268.81. Commodity prices and shares got a boost from a weaker dollar. A large amount of suspense persists on the outlook of the budget, which has left the investors on the tenterhooks. With LIC expecting to invest further 100 billion rupees in the equity markets by mid-March, many hope to quickly ride past the 5,000 mark around the budget times. With major Asian markets back with a bang, the Indian markets are expected to open higher. Nifty might attempt 4,930 on the higher side. However, one must not forget possibilities of a partial and calibrated rollback of the fiscal stimulus. Another daunting task for the government is to cap inflation, which is almost on the verge of crossing double digits. Among the other news, the NSE will introduce 11 additional stocks in the F&O segment. The 11 new securities include Videocon Industries Limited, Godrej Industries Limited, Adani Enterprises, Apollo Tyres, Arriva T&D India, BGR Energy Systems, Fortis Healthcare, JN Irrigation Systems, McLeod Russell India, Mundra Port and SEZ, and OnMobile Global. Tata Steel's consolidated profits were down by 42% at rupees 4.73 billion due to the poor performance of its European arm Corus. Bharti Airtel said that the acquisition of Zen Group's African assets would result in a total payout of $9 billion, which includes any loans payable by the operating companies to Zen Group. L&T has lined up an investment of more than $400 million to expand its shipping capacity, especially for defense, by mid-2011. India and the 10-nation Southeast Asian trading bloc are expected to widen their trade engagement by signing in October a free trade agreement which will include services and investments. SEBI has agreed to change the auction norms for follow-on public offers to follow institutional bidders lower their bids in response to a request which was received from the Department of Disinvestment. The recommendations of the day are: Century Textile, there is a recommendation to traders to buy the stock at current levels and up to the levels of rupees 490 for an initial target of rupees 525. It is advisable to maintain a stop loss of rupees 484. Bharat Forge, the stock is expected to rally in the short term. Traders can buy the stock between the range of rupees 254 to rupees 259 for a target of rupees 275, and it is advisable to maintain a stop loss at rupees 249. Thank you.